Hey everybody, in distance here, back for more of my La-Mulana 2 playthrough. So I have done pretty much precisely what I had said at the back of my last playing session. So I've sat here and been spawning some fairies in the Shrine of the Frost Giants. And the pattern, while I didn't mark it down last time, feels suspiciously familiar. I've been marking it down this time. It's healing, healing, weapon, healing, treasure, healing, key. Which is what I've just spawned now. So there's part of me that's kind of wondering, hey, is this, like, entirely deterministic? Or something. Which, you know, okay. Anyway, so I've made the decision that I want to science rather than go straight to the eternal prison. So that's precisely what I'm going to do here. We'll kind of see what happens. And she's not doing anything. So I guess this isn't a special, a key fairy special. So let's get our ass over to the Eternal Prison and see what we can get to happen here. So I don't know if it's gonna activate in this room or if I need to drag her into the room below. Looks like the room below, maybe. Hopefully, maybe, kinda, sorta. Something in here? For the love of God. Okay. So it seems I was right on a couple of fronts. One, that green glow is indeed coming from some sort of sigil. But the other side of it being, actually, I don't know if I mentioned this, because I remember trying to go through a list and then only getting through two items when I had thought of three. Anyway, the other one that I had thought of was this sort of scenario where some of the time the key fairy does something, and other times it's doing something else. So, what do we get? Yes! It's so good! Oh, and then three extra bombs, just like that. You're a bro, game. I also did pick up... I scooped up some, a little bit of money when I got the treasure fairy, so if you're noticing a discrepancy in the amount of cash that I have, that would certainly be it. I mean, I'm not gonna spawn it and then just be like, oh, I'm just gonna sit here. Like, obviously, I'm gonna go and grab everything I can. So, now that I have bombs, the world is my oyster. I mean, it's not really. But there are places that I'm interested in throwing them at. Although, it would absolutely be in my best interest to save it before throwing them. I mean, after all, it's like, oh, I'm gonna throw a whole bunch of bombs at stuff, and then I throw them at something, and nothing happens. Then it's like, okay, well, that was stupid. Because, yeah, we don't have a whole lot. So let's see what happens here. Oh, oh, it's so good. Ever spoke of that which will end all life, of what is known as the mother, those who seek must speak the name of Modir? Alright. So now, see now the problem is that I've gotten into a sense of, okay, well, all of the places that I want to write this crap down. Because I have I have my little sheet on mantras, but then in a second I'm going to be chanting it, and then I'm going to be like drawing it down on a piece of paper, which is, you know. So. End all life. Got that? Before I go about the process of, Yes! Okay. Sweater. I'm pretty sure I have a lamp charge right now. Pretty sure. Maybe I should not have the bombs equipped. Yeah. What do you have to say for yourself? Very well. The mother is a creature that fell into these lands. The giants understood her wish. To return to home. Okay. Thanks, Elvis. I love your music. Okay. So. So that hooks me up with that. Which is cool. Oh, man. Oh man, indeed. So let me see. Was that crap about the? So I don't have enough to get my hands on the elixir or whatever at this point in time. Is what is the horn blast of the end? Disappears into the wind of those who wish for eternity. And then night continues for eternity toward the child's road left by the mother. So the ones that I'm missing still for that would be end, night, and child. Because I have, I've got wind, obviously. Wish and eternity I have. Mother I have, and road is the other meaning for the birth. So, still need more for that. What was the... Let me see. I saved that. Mimir as well, of Twine Liquor. So grant the mother's wish for a howl for that which is missing. So, no howling. And what was it that I needed for... Scream in the room where Echidna is worshipped, make your wishes heard. So I can go and do that. Before I do, though, there's one or two things that I wanted to at least try with the bombs. So I'm not really sure at this point about... how exactly the key fairy stuff works. Because that just straight up opened something, whereas this, I still have that weird key symbol associated with it. So because of the clink, I was thinking, oh, well, it'll have something to do with maybe bombs? But I'm not sure that's the case. And yet, it is. Of course, I've already broken this pot, thanks to that fucking weapon fairy. Which isn't really important, because, well, you know, I get money. I guess. So that's that one. This would be nice. This would be real nice. If I just came down here and then, you know, broke the thing with the thing, and then I could just spawn them on my jack. That would be great. So I might have to blow myself up to do it. But I'm willing to make that sacrifice. Ah, okay. So I still don't know what the deal is with this. The only other thing that I'm... Something that's coming to mind with it is just the idea. I'm going to quit the menu and continue so I get my bomb back. So clearly that's not the right answer there. Like, I'm trying to think of other things that might have an impact on that. I suppose there's, it's probably faster going the other way, isn't it? Ow! Sure. Let's go here. Yeah, I'm just gonna go the other way. No! Don't leave me! I love you! Okay. Ooh. That was close. Everybody's a comedian. Fuck, I'll go the other way. I'll spend the way. What was the thing? So yes, other things. Now that I have my grubby little mitts on the gauntlet, which is cool. I suppose I could go over there and see if there's a discrepancy in, like, maybe I need to be attacking faster? I don't know. It didn't seem to... Because, like, when I tried opening it up for the first time, like, I whipped at it a lot. You know? Like a lot. Jeez. It's gonna take some getting used to, the faster weapons. Okay, so. How fast is a rapier? Nice. God, you really have to mash for the best attack speed for the knife now. So the things that I was thinking here, I mean, let's... This isn't that much faster because every second whip is like... is below me? Doesn't seem to be doing it. I suppose there's a possibility of something like... like I'm supposed to whip in some particular direction or something. Like in some combination, like it's a frickin' lock or something. Still don't know what to do about that. Them. Let's go, then, to the village of departure. Time to make my wishes heard. Okay, if nothing happens this time, I'm gonna be pretty fucking choked. Dude, fucking boss. It's interesting. Okay. So. The Ulfer spoke of that which resists extinction. Of what is known as the children, those who seek must speak. The name of Barn. I was kind of chuckling about it because it's like, I don't know if anyone knows the expression, like, well, were you raised in a barn? Close the bloody door! Awesome. So... yeah, well now I need another lamp charge, because I have to go back to Aldous. I should be able to get one quickly by coming down here. Okay. Let's go here. I am not used to the attack speed. Yeah, I kind of did. Very well. The child is that which is born to leave the nest. The giants referred to such as a howl for independence. Okay. So I now have all but one of the mantras. So howl and child. So there was some howling I was supposed to be doing. I think as part of, like, the Mimir as well. Just kind of flipping through my notes a little bit here. Looking for other things. Crocodile head in Maud's room likes to eat grenades. Sure like to feed him a few. So there's still places that I would want to try using grenades. Or not grenades, excuse me. Key fairies. In particular, was it Phobos? Was saying, you know, bring like a key fairy to a secret room in the Takamagahara Shrine. Which could be referring to the Dragon Path room. So that might be something of some benefit. I'm also going to be potentially able to obtain the La-Mulana software, where I have to bomb to the bottom right of a sexy girl. So I need to, I guess, appropriately identify the sexy girl, and then, you know, see where it is that I'm supposed to be bombing. Which is, well, kind of figure that out, I guess. Yeah. I'm not seeing what I'm looking for here. Though this one... Where are my... my grid papers over here? Okay. So I only have one mantra that is left to be discovered. Though it's kind of... It's difficult to know what it's referring to at this sort of point. Because the one that I got was the one labeled so the one on the field map, or one of the field maps, was the one to be found in the Eternal Prison Gloom. So that was the first one that I got. And then one of those symbols is certainly referring to Barn. But then the other one, it's like somewhere way off the field map. And I mean, putting in that particular direction, I'm not sure even which field map location is the one that I got from the Inferno Cavern. So, like, even... It's like, even if I was able to identify that, like, would it be a clue toward getting what the other mantra is? I don't know. So this was the one, the Pedestal of the Dark Star Lord... is summoned by mantra, summoned to where the pyramid is held aloft. And then... Yeah, I had written down... these locations. And then tied them to roof, moon, mother, wall, and fire. So that might be something to take a look at. Also because I have more mantras, and I've been drawing them down, which is something that I should certainly take a look at. It's just taking, reviewing what this looks like here. It's kind of interesting, because it doesn't seem to include, like, a lot of other mantras that I have. This one's difficult to see, if I'm honest. I wish that the display was, like, a little bit bigger. If I went and scanned the original tablet, then I'd certainly be able to see it better. But just from my eye, like, from right here, it really looks like... Sea, heaven, sun, moon, fire... That's it. Maybe. Okay. But I know another path. And then, yeah, this one. Mimir's Well is the Well of Divine Liquor. Grant the Mother's Wish with a howl for that which is missing. So what is this? I'm not sure I've seen this before. But the... Like, the little pit... on the lower left with the fluid, like, kind of makes me think it might be one of the hot springs that are in the ruins, but I don't recognize the background. Don't need that anymore. Oh, man. So, okay, I'm gonna write these or draw these out as best I can. No. Okay, so. So, this one, and we have... Oh man, this is gonna be a great drawing. Pardon me. Alright. Yeah, it's basically the same thing, only, you know. Only upside down. If I was a talented artist, I might be able to just draw it based on what I've already drawn. You know, if I was a talented artist, which, you know, like anyone is under that illusion. Okay. So, so the mantra in question that I'm thinking was what? This, right? Fire, heaven, yeah. These five. I mean, that looks like it. What does it say? To where the pyramid... Summon to where the pyramid is held aloft? Thank you. wouldn't... I mean, I feel like I'm missing something still, you know? You mind? Summoned to where the pyramid is held aloft. What's this one say again? The crystal that enseals a pyramid form, the destiny tablet, proof of the Dark Star Lord. You have assembled both. Speak words of fealty to the Dark Star Lord. Offer crystal at the pedestal of prayer. The pyramid will respond to the Lord. So I need the crystal first. Before I'm even really tempted at doing anything with this, chanting nonsense. Which, well, further represents an issue for me, because I'm still stuck on how to get the pyramid crystal. Which has been vexing me for quite some time now. Good stuff. I had a thought of something that I wanted to do or try, but it's, it is gone. Let's see. Oh yes, that was what I wanted to look at. I wanted to go to the Ancient Chaos and take a look at the the hot spring down there. Sweet! I'm still very suspicious of that thing. And not really sure what to do about it. I wonder... like out to get me. It's not very nice. Yeah, I mean, it doesn't look anything like this, either. Right? Like, there's no pyramids in the background, no nothing. There was something in the room over here that I kind of wanted to look at real quick. Probably nothing, but... So there's, like, this area down here. That I'm kind of interested in getting into. Wasn't sure if I could maybe, like... jump up in here or something. But it doesn't seem as though that's the case. Alright. I don't want to be underneath the damn thing when it's thingy tipping over. If this is indeed what I think that it's leading to. Can I, like, push it or something? No. Push it from the other side. Yeah. And that's a jump I can easily make without the feather. Try it out, but it's not gonna do me any good because I can't actually I don't have my starting position for which I'm pretty sure I'll need to kill, or at least the, I'm pretty sure, my current best idea is that I would need to kill, Vidofnir, so that I can enter, so that I can get into here from the Eternal Prison Gloom side, and then start down the path that I've laid out that makes the most sense. At which point I'd wind up here, coming out of that door, and then, yeah, I'd have to jump down into this pit, come over here, I guess. I'll need to be careful about that jump down. I don't want to fire through here. Because it's going to be one big marathon to get to hell. And, you know, if I arrive there with not a hell of a lot of... not a hell of a lot of health, I could be in trouble. Still not sure what that is about. But then, yeah. From here... yeah, I'd easily be able to get up here without the feather. I don't know if the position of this thing will reset, but I can move it over there. Or can I? Yes, I can. Yes, I can. Because the last item, which is associated with, was it Svafa? Or whatever? The last gate is, the Glove of Power. Yeah. Which is what I need to actually shove this over, but I will have it, and I'll be able to jump over here. And then, yeah, it's just a piddling amount. Now, just to double check on this side. Yeah, I can sort of easily progress through here. At which point I will arrive. Excuse me? The fuck is that? What? Maybe that's a result of having killed Hreis Velgir. Which has... where is my map? Okay. So this one... yeah. That's another one. At this sort of gate. So, hang on. So what's the room that I'm in right now? Okay, I'm in this room. So now we have gate... gate number 18, I guess? And 18 is... red. And this is the... yeah. And that's Glove of Power. So, where does this go then? Oh! Okay. Okay. So, so gate 18 exits onto the final gate, number 12. So maybe that's the, excuse me, I just banged the mic. Maybe that's the correct play. But then that raises a different question. Damn it, I actually wanted to go again. I just have to wait. Because I'm thinking, okay, if I have to go in that gate instead of going into the final gate, is it actually possible for me to get up there without all of my items? Come on. No! Ah, crap. I was just dicking around. Fuck. There we go. This would be the quickest way to get back to where I wanted to be. So... yeah, the answer is yes. It'll be really easy to get here with without my movement items. Because, yeah. Basically, I'd come down to this point, and then I can just drop down here. Sure. At which point, yeah. Like, I can just... you can curve around these really easily and then jump from there to there. And then go in this gate. But again, I think there is the, death awaits you if you descend below. Why does this thing exist? I was wondering if maybe there was like a secret in the wall or something like that. And you needed the elevator. Or not elevator, the floating platform to get to it. That does not appear to be the case. But yeah, so this doesn't really change too much. It might change like the very little, like the last sequence of the path. Which is to say, instead of dropping down below and attempting to enter the final gate, I'll just walk into this one. That would be the first thing that I would try anyway. But it doesn't change the fact that I can't start on the path. Because to start on the path, I think I need to kill Vidofnir. To kill Vidofnir, I need the power of the flame. To get the power of the flame, I need... to get the power of the flame, I'll need to speak with Osiris. Oh, man. Yeah, I'll need to speak to Osiris. In order to speak to Osiris, I need to pass Anubis's three trials. In order to pass Anubis's three trials, Anubis needs to start speaking to me. In order for Anubis to start speaking to me, I need the... I need the proof of judgment. And in order to get the proof of judgment, I need... I need to not get eaten by the fucking crocodile. And then pass Maat's ritual. However, that all throws down being, yeah. I mean, there's things. Lots of things. So, still can't do anything with Prophecy Part 1, because I do not have a mantra that means night. Part 2, I've already done. Part 3... I could do, but this is, yeah. Saw the world of end, the fall of the mighty, its inhabitants scorched away by conflict. Yggdrasil awakens. Saw the red star that grants a wish that is howled at the final gate. So I have the mantras to accomplish this. Mantras. Wish and Howl are both that I have. I have both of them now. The question is, what's this final gate? I suppose it could be talking about the final gate in Hell, but... like, I'm just looking at the diagram here, and it doesn't seem... anything like that? I'm not sure I've really seen this anywhere. Part 4 has to do with excessive power and, you know, murderous blood-drenched intent. In order to do anything with that, I'm going to need one more mantra. And then this one? I don't know. I mean, it's pretty obvious what I need to chant. It's just not so obvious right now where I need to chant it. This stuff, though, a battle that will occur at the final land... pardon me. Sun, moon, and stars watch over the earth. This could be drawing reference to Nibiru. Which is... I actually don't know. I don't... huh. Maybe not. I mean, I was thinking that... I was having a thought for a second that I would need to solve... yeah. Sorry, I'm kind of mixed up in terms of what I'm thinking about. So there's the Nine Soul Gate that's down here by the Spiral Boat. Yeah, right there. And then there's like whatever this is up here. But then I think... yeah, so like that door is... I get there from the Hall of Malice. And then I think, what do you call it? Nibiru was said to be on the other side of the Dark Star. Lord's Mausoleum. Actually, it'd be faster to go this way. I just wanted to take a look at the different hot springs. Again, I don't really recognize any of them from the whole, like, Well of Mimir thing. But, yeah, why not, right? May as well take a look. Doesn't exactly hurt anything. So this one's the closest, but it's still not... It still doesn't really resemble what I'm kind of looking at. Okay. Not you. Bombed the bottom right of a certain sexy girl. Who is this sexy girl of who you speak? Probably not her. All these damn snake women wearing, like, frickin' hair bras. I mean, really. How am I supposed to find this on the back of that hand? So I do want to go through a few more of my notes, and then maybe I'll return to this a little bit later. I know this is like a little bit of a shorter segment right now, but I don't have too much more that I'd go on for the moment. You know, in terms of like, hey, what would I... What would I move on next? I'm still not sure on the whole... Like, I very strongly get the idea that, I did actually hard save here, didn't I? Yeah, I did. I mean, it may be the case that I don't, sure, that I don't actually have what I need to solve this down here, but, man, it feels like I have everything that I would need to actually be able to address this, and I just don't. You know, I'm just not putting the pieces together. I mean, the images for the mantra chanting for mother and child... I mean, maybe it looks like the Sigil of Life with the most generous interpretation. But it was a thought that I had had. So, in the celebration of entertaining thoughts that I have, yeah, I didn't think so either. Run! Yeah, well. Anyway, I'm gonna come back to this later. When I do come back to it later, I may start in a similar fashion. I mean, it depends on what I find from scouring over my notes or whatever. Yet again. But I might start with grinding for another key fairy just so that I can get a crack at whatever is in the dragon path room. Possibly the ring, as the philosopher was alluding to. But I don't know if that's actually the room that he was talking to or if I'm just conflating it. But yeah, we'll see. Hey, everybody. So, as promised, I suppose. Yeah, spawning key fairies. Although, I did do a number of other things. Though I kind of want to see, just before I fire into all of that, the spawning pattern has been the same, so I expect this to be a key fairy. And it is. So, that's kind of cool. Kind of. Anyway, let's go to the Takamagahara Shrine. I'm actually not sure if the key fairy is going to engage a room earlier. Or in an earlier room, rather. Because there's a tablet in this room that says, you know, bear the small key, the secret will be laid bare. But, yeah, I guess not, huh? Anyway, let's head to the dragon path room. Interesting. So, I mean, unless I need to be, like, deeper into the room. Oh, yep. There it is. So this, what I've just picked up here, actually, is the reason why I have more money and less weights. I mean, I have more money because I had to spawn the treasure fairy and I'm not going to let it go to waste. But the reason why I have less weights was because I was wandering about. I wanted to see if I had missed anything about the golden rock. And just wandering, looking at tablets. Sometimes it helps me think. Instead of just poring over my notes. So that was precisely what I did. Didn't come out with a lot, but a couple of things that were making me think a little bit. So normally when I do that sort of wandering, I just quit out and I don't actually save any of my progress. The reason why I haven't done that in this case is that because I recently got the bombs, there are plenty of pots around the ruins that have bombs in them. So I've been picking them up as I go, and I thought, I don't really want to ditch all of those bombs. I mean, I'm adding like a little bit of time played to the counter and whatever, but I'm sure no one's going to be particularly sore about, oh, I didn't get to see hidden wander around the... Like, use your fucking imagination. Anyway, I expect this is the ring. Yeah, so that was the thing that Phobos had to say. I don't know if I recorded his... Yes, I didn't. I just made a note of it. Anyway, that's cool. An accessory thought to have been passed on by a master warrior, equipped to boost dexterity, improving weapon-throwing technique. Holy smokes. Yes! Okay, so you throw more caltrops. I just kind of want to... Maybe this is a good opportunity to just save so I'm not burning through a whole bunch of sub-weapons unnecessarily. Holy smokes, that thing killed him? Okay then. Sure. get all of those back. So, yeah, I've basically gone through everywhere. And just, like, looked at tablets, done things. There were two spots that I hadn't really checked, but it was time to spawn another fairy, so I was like, eh, I'll go and do that. There aren't really many references to the Golden Rock throughout the ruins, at least in the places that I have access to. It may be that there are more places in the ruins that I have access to, but haven't been to. So the first one is, yeah, the Golden Rock keeps the crystal from ascending to heaven. It will pass to the hand with the mark of life. I've been repeating that one over and over again. The other one is the one that I have in text tracks. The secret hidden by the Golden Rock, hidden behind the wall, pinned by the Golden Rock, with the attached mural. There was another tablet here, because I was just thinking, like, mark of life, what could it possibly mean? So there was a tablet in the Shrine of the Frost Giants, which is a hint to go and get, or how to get, to the birth sigil. And it just says, life is begotten of the cold soil. The birth sigil lies down, or lies in the depths of deep, deep snow. Meaning, you know, like, you have to jump, like, on high and then fall through the snow, and then you can get into the, you can get into the room with the thing. But it was just like, ooh, life, mark of life? It's just a mentioning of life, so I don't really think it has anything to do with that. That was kind of it. The other thing that I came across, though, just reviewing... also, I didn't really find anywhere that looked like this, which is somewhat annoying because I have all of the mantras that I would need to chant for that. Like, the closest thing that I can think of is the, at the top of the Frost Giant Shrine, there's, like, a pyramid, but it doesn't have pillars like this. Also, it doesn't have, you know, water or anything, or a head. So I don't know. I mean, this says liquor as well, not divine liquor, though. Liquor passed down by a local sage or hidden treasure allows one to escape death but once. If you seek it, you must make the climb by Odin's side. Keep the deity's words on your lips as you make for the great cup. Could be something to chant at the chalice, to be honest, because, like, Mimir was one of the Odin, if memory serves. I should be able to... not here. I should be able to find that. Or confirm that, rather, quite easily. So all I need to do is scan a bust of Mimir. Because I was thinking that the chalice up there, like the giant cup, was associated with the other thing. Like the, you know... what is it? You know, blah blah blah, the end, mother, yada yada yada. You know what I'm talking about. There were another... this was one that I did come across, so when I was looking around, I took a look at this tablet in the Hall of Malice. So I've already solved this puzzle. Scream in the room where a kid and his worship make your wishes heard. The thing that I found really suspicious about this, though, is that... like, depicted on this mural, you have the... excuse me. So, on the... so, on the right side of this mural, you have Mother, although it's flipped horizontally. But you have that mantra, and then next to it, or what Echidna is holding, is the mantra for, was it child? Barn? Right. So Echidna is holding that, but right next to Echidna's shoulder is the life sigil. And I was like, why is that there? And I can't really say, because, like, the life sigil, as it says here, it's the La-Mulanese character for three. So, like, I was almost thinking, oh, is it a hint to where Echidna's room is? As in, you know, like, it's in this field of La-Mulana. But that would be the wrong sigil, because the sigil associated with the Inferno Cavern in La-Mulana is the number 5, which is the, it looks like a claw mark horizontally. There's like 3 lines that kind of go across. So it's like, why is that there? So, I don't know. Is it like... so, Scream and Wishes was what I was supposed to put in there. So these two, so like, is this another meaning for life? It doesn't really make any sense to me because it's already got... it already has 2 meanings, but I don't know. So anyway, I'm gonna go down here and I'm going to chant the wind mantra at this stupid bust. And nothing's going to happen. So, yeah, his severed head lives on through Odin's magic. Okay, maybe he wasn't one of the Odin. It's beheaded by the veneer, though, so it would... that would make sense. Balls. So no dice on that. But, yeah. It is, I don't know. I still find it weird that's there. And maybe I'm drawing connections where there are no connections, but who knows. Anyway, why don't I go and try, I'm gonna go to the Divine Fortress and then do the thing. The other thing that came up, though, just before I get onto that, was the discussion with Pengu, talking about, you know, the power of the Anunnaki, Darkstar, Nibiru, yada yada. And it says here, the stone tablet on which allegiance to the Anunnaki was pledged, with the power of the stars sealed inside. Well. All of the stuff about the... like, there's a ton of other notes about, like, the crystal and it having the power of the stars and that sort of stuff. Right? So, my notes on the Dark Star Lord's mausoleum. So I'm pretty sure they're in there. I mean, I assume that this one has to do with the chalice, which is why I'm like, oh, I don't have the things that I need to chant for it. That is the medicine of the eternal life, sought after by countless deities, a gift of paradise. It restores life after death, and then it has the horn blast at the end, disappears into the wind of they who wish for eternity. Night continues for eternity towards child's road left by the mother. So I was like, dang it, I don't have night. Or end. So I can't do that. But, yeah, maybe I'll just go up there and chant this. Again, I'm not thinking it's gonna result in great success. Yeah, obtain the crystal that enseals a pyramid. Then all hidden in slant shall be revealed. The truth of the pyramid will be exposed. Forfeit the yada yada. I could have sworn. Like, I've just read this tablet. I know that it's... irritating. Yeah, the pyramid crystal restrains the power of the stars. It wreaks havoc on that which hides the power of the dark star. So... So, I mean, going from this, it's like the stone tablet on which allegiance to the Anunnaki was pledged with the power of the stars sealed inside. It's like... And then... There's your pyramid crystal hidden in the wall. And then, I don't know, I was tying this, because it's like the stone tablet on which the allegiance of the Anunnaki was pledged, but, like, the Anunnaki manipulated the first children into joining or aiding them. So it's like, is that the false tablet that's being referred to in the Gate of the Dead? And despite the fact that I've just gone through, like, all this, I'm not sure which tablet it is that it's referring to, in terms of, like, this allegiance to the Anunnaki. So, I don't know. Anyway. Mother Howl missing. So let's go up there and see what we can do. Fine. I have a bunch of cash. I should probably buy a few more things, too. Like some weights. I could buy a bounce shot. And then, what else? I suppose I could buy the pistol. This isn't the... I mean, it says it right here, you know? That is the medicine of the eternal life, sought after by countless deities. A gift of paradise that restores life after death. Anyway, we're rolling in here. Bow! Yeah, I didn't think so either. Damn it. yay. Okay. Selma. So, okay. Okay. Let me go to Valhalla. I want to look at what this jackass up here has to say specifically about Chang and the Quandra. I've spoken to him a number of times and he's never changed what he's saying. So, if you see a busted Mimir, then there's something hidden nearby. Think for yourself to figure out which mantra you should incant. By the way, I've heard that chanting the Yor mantra, representing Earth, in front of that huge rock at the roots of Yggdrasil will cause something pretty bad to happen. Okay. So, let's think for a second about what... what I might be doing wrong with respect to this. Okay? So let's say that that is indeed the mantra I am supposed to chant. After all, I mean, I get, like, the whole puzzle-solving sound when it happens, which isn't exactly a guarantee that I've done something correctly. It might just be the game is taking a massive dump right on my head. But let's say that this is the first step in something that I should be doing. Right? So, like, that's the first thing that I should do. Now, the second thing that I have been doing is coming down here and then destroying the column. Ah, yeah, this is the one. The Golden Rock stores the power of the stars. Christ, I didn't write that one down. I'm an idiot. One idiot! Alright. Stores the power of the stars. Yep. So, almost certainly, I can't do anything with this still. Yeah, I can't do anything with that. Can I... stop it. So those aren't gonna do anything. What else could I do to save myself from being absolutely blown out? The Lamp of Time doesn't do anything for me. And that breaks the platform, so it's not like you can take cover under it. Stores the power of the stars. World and the fall of the mighty, its inhabitants scorched away by conflict. Saw the red star that grants a wish that is howled at the final gate. It's a giant rock. Apparently a final gate. She sees the final land's vortex after price being paid, then memory of the final gate being pried upon by excessive power and the price it demands, and murderous blood-drenched in tent. And then this one, the sun has no idea of the power it has. The moon has no idea that it has power at all. Dazzling stars remain, smoke and flame rage, flames frolic in the heavens. For the mighty have vanished, for its true form cannot be seen by starlight alone. I mean, I'm pretty sure I've chanted sun and moon there before anyway. Pretty sure I have. That doesn't do anything anyway. Goddamn, dude. Name of the room doesn't really help out much either. It's just golden rock. Very, very informative. Push this? No. Yeah, I don't know. I'm still stuck with this one. Anyway. Man, I have been dicking around for a while. Anyway, I'll come back to this later, I guess. It's pretty rough in that sense of having gone over the having gone over all of your notes and feeling like you're really not making any progress and wandering the ruins and not really figuring anything out. So maybe I'll maybe I'll sit on it for a day or two. Just see if anything falls out. Yeah. Alright. Catch you next time.